Dr. Itula estimates that more than 900,000 Namibians live in informal settlements in urban areas where access to proper sanitation and roads are limited. This is the picture that he wants to reverse if given the mandate to govern.
When you go to Dama, some of the people that work in some of our restaurants and hotels here, they get away from work at 11 o'clock. The taxi can only go as far as this because there's so much sun. There's no roads, no electricity, no water, and manpower is just next door, and you've got the big rivers here. Now, how do you explain that?
Dr. Itula told the gathering that he would not move to State House until 80% sanitation coverage is achieved. A dentist by profession, he also promised to reform the country's healthcare system, education, public service, and the agriculture sector. And his political career, he says, speaks for itself and explains why people should vote for him.
When you go to the polls, forget about Itula. You need to go and vote for the principles that Itula stands for the convictions that Itula stands for. And what you need to understand is this, that I'm the only truly nominated candidate for the presidency, because before I registered myself, I needed to get over 500 people in each region, and instead of the 7,000 required, I got over 18,000. Now I've got more mandate than anybody.
In his address, he also promised to review the allocation of fishing quotas to benefit all Namibians, while Namibians 21 years and above will own land by charging $1,000 per plot, as well as make housing affordable.
Okay, let's go.
To achieve this, he says, graduates from vocational training centers will build houses and do away with the middleman. Dr. Itula reiterated his stand on the electronic voting machines, saying that
credibility was
questionable,
absolutely crowded, when they brought everybody
in. Of Namibia to go back to the ballot boxes. Okay.